Today we are going to discuss the soluble insulin or crystalline insulin or regular insulin. Regular insulin is also called as crystalline or soluble insulin. This is short acting preparation, means duration of action is 6 to 8 hours. It is soluble in nature. Crystalline zinc insulin. Crystalline zinc insulin, it forms hexamers after subcutaneous injection. It forms hexamer after subcutaneous injection. That's why it is slowly absorbed. Onset of action is within 30 minutes. Hence, it should be administered 30 minutes before meal. It's a short acting, means duration of action is just 6 to 8 hours. You can give this soluble insulin or regular insulin via subcutaneous route, intramuscular route or intravenous route. In case of emergency, you can prefer intravenous route in case of diabetic ketoacidosis. Diabetic ketoacidosis is a life-threatening medical emergency. So in that case, you can prefer intravenous route. And in case of diabetes mellitus, you can prefer subcutaneous route because it gives smooth, steady and slow plasma concentration of insulin, which resembles physiological secretion of insulin. Preparations available: 40 units per ml, 100 units per ml and 500 units per ml. Then we have neutral protamine hagedorn, or it is called as isoflurane insulin. So what is the difference between regular insulin and isoflurane insulin? First of all, we'll see what is this neutral protamine hagedorn. Neutral means it is stable at a neutral pH. That's why it is neutral. Protamine. Regular insulin is complexed with protamine. To become more stable. That's why there is a name protamine, and hagedorn is the name of scientist which discovered this isoflurane insulin. So it is an intermediate acting preparation. Intermediate acting preparation means duration of action is 10 to 20 hours. It's a cloudy solution, and insulin is complex with zinc and protamine. In regular insulin, there is only zinc, and in isoflurane insulin, there is, apart from zinc, we have protamine to make that preparation more stable. It slowly dissociates on subcutaneous administration, means it also forms hexamers on subcutaneous injection. Onset of action is delayed, like it will take 1 to 2 hours for onset of action. Duration of action is 10 to 20 hours, so it should be given once or twice daily, and most preferred route is subcutaneous.